Welcome to part four of Fran's impeller pump. And out of frustration and desperation, I took the previous model that had lots of bodies, and I suppressed all the bodies except for this quadrant. And I did from Design Modeler file export, and I pulled out a parasolid file so that I could create a whole new construction and import just that one file, so you can when it's new you can import. So I imported the parasolid and then opened it in Design Modeler to help diagnose what's going on, and I think I found something pretty interesting, because as we go through these bodies, when you see a body that you recognize, I was going to hide it, so as each body is visible, it gets hidden, and we're going to keep marching through here. And what we're going to end up with is some one extra body that shouldn't be there, or really two extra bodies, this one and this one. So there's a very thin piece of material that is causing lots of problems, and those two bodies were however they were constructed, they should have been suppressed from this model. So if we pick that body and go to body, that is body 14, so I'm going to suppress that body, and this body I go to body, that is body 1, suppress that body. That could substantially improve the ability of these things to mesh. In fact, I'm going to show all bodies, and just to be sure that these bodies aren't influencing anything anymore, I'm going to do another export. Clean, just go up a couple of levels to the impeller level. So I want to save this as, I like to go out to parasolid, clean.txt, and then close this off too, and just bring in a fresh mesh, say here, and we'll import that. We'll browse for the clean file, and we'll open that in Design Modeler. And we may need to form a new part after we do the generate. Yes, 14 parts, not 16, and form new part so that it meshes across. And we will go ahead and bring that into meshing. And there's potentially still some problems here, because we have what looks like Maybe not. Maybe we're in good shape now. So the mesh, let's go to physics preferences, CFD, and let's go to sizing. Maybe we'll have curvature and proximity. We'll go for medium, and we'll set also the default is 3. 5mm element size, tets maybe we'll make that 10. Well, I don't think we're gonna, maybe 5 is better. And here, 4, 3. So, let's give it a trial run. I never know what that means, but anyway, let's let it run. Make sure it can at least fill this with some good elements and have no errors. I won't make you wait for that. So we actually did not get a mesh. It says the mesh did not generate any modes. The geometry may have been defeatured away. Now the defeature size is defaulting to a small value, but I did notice something that we can go count the edges outside of this, and the edges, let me go to my CAD system where I imported this and where I found the bodies that shouldn't be, which is the 1 and 3. There's one of them, and I think the other one is the top one. Maybe not. There's the two bodies we don't want. So body 16, I'm going to suppress. We have the same terminology, and I'm going to suppress that body. So I want to unsuppress these ones. So let's count the edges here, where I just because probably can do this in Design Modeler, but I don't know how. Here I do know how, and that is to grab this, and it just counted the edges. So there should only be 199 edges in this model. So let's see what we see when we're meshing, and we're gonna clear generated data, and we're gonna go ahead and mesh. But let's look at the edges. So it's initializing. And in a minute there, 233 edges. So, and did you see how many times it's going to edges and seeing only partial edges? So that's the problem, is the there's multiple edges along this boundary. And we can see it's multicolored. It's black and purple and black and purple. So we don't have good topology. That should just be one color, that edge, and that lack of quality in the topology is screwing up the meshing. So instead of 199 edges, which is what my CAD system can see, this is seeing 233 edges. Those extra edges are messing with the topology. So let's see what we can do about that in the next video.